Hello everyone, welcome to today's video. Amid the rise in the cases of COVID-19 all over India, where the cases are almost touching 3.5 lakh plus, it is not a very favorable situation for us. And we certainly do need to take measures as engineers in particular. And today, I will be talking about the role of us as engineers in this time of pandemic, what we have been doing and what we can do as engineers. We have often been criticized for not being that effective. As a parts course or as a degree, engineers have not been in the limelight, whereas doctors, the frontline workers in particular, have been appreciated a lot. But let me tell you, engineers, as engineers, we are doing a lot and we have a lot of things to do, constructive things to do, rather than sitting idle or criticizing the government on Facebook or on any other social media platform. We have quite a bit of interesting things that we can actually plan and do as engineers. And now let us talk about what we have already done in this pandemic situation, what we have been doing and how we are providing as a good source of help towards the coronavirus or COVID-19 affected patients in this time of pandemic. So as you know, there is an oxygen crunch throughout the country, and the oxygen plants in particular throughout the country have been tremendously effective in trying to produce extra amount of oxygen by stopping the certain processes of production. Like, let me cite an example. Recently, ONGC has declared that they will supply about 150 metric ton of oxygen per day to the government for its oxygen requirements, and it is partially throttling the production of methyl glycol, which would have otherwise required that amount of oxygen. In fact, in our plant, we are working tirelessly day in and day out to produce about extra amount of about 40 to 50 metric tons of liquid oxygen so that it can be made available to the COVID-19 affected patients. As chemical engineers in particular, if I talk that all throughout India, in ONGC, in IOCL, we know wherever there is a process involving the requirement of oxygen, we are throttling all of those processes. In fact, recently, Supreme Court has given the permission of partially opening the sterlite industries. Yes, after 2 years since the ban of the sterlite industries in Tuticorin or Tuticorin, it has finally given the permission of standalone oxygen system or oxygen process production start. That is, only the oxygen plant will be running in the sterlite proper to produce the required amount of oxygen in Tamil Nadu. So all the industries that are there producing the oxygen are working in tirelessly, including us, day in and day out to produce oxygen. And these processes are basically designed and operated by chemical engineers like us, like you watching the video. So we are working tirelessly day in and day out. We may not be, our efforts may not be visible, but it's always there. We are trying to go to each and every bed of the patients and trying to produce that extra amount of oxygen that is required there in this pandemic. Apart from this, as we know that we are increasing the production of remdesivir by Cipla. Many of my friends personally, many of my juniors do work in Cipla itself, and it's a proud moment to say that a chemical engineer is actually involved in the increase in production of this particular vaccines or medicines, whatever we talk of. The primary procedure of production or the composition of the chemicals are decided by the chemists. Hats off to them, kudos to them. But when it comes to the production in bulk, the processes need to be more effective, and the productivity has to be increased. The availability of the machines or the OE, overall equipment effectiveness, has to be increased, and that is done by mechanical engineers, chemical engineers, other types of engineers, instrument engineers, to make the process more efficient and more quick so that we can produce more and more vaccines and remdesivir medicine. We have recently heard that the government is upheaving the production of remdesivir, and it's going to go threefold within 20 days, upcoming 20 days, as declared by the central ministry. So there also we see the involvement of engineers. We see the involvement of pharmaceutical engineers in the basic design and of the composition of the vaccines and the medicines that are required for the COVID-19 patients. So as engineers, oxygen, medicines, vaccines, we see everywhere there is this core engineering involved. Apart from this, when we talk of engineers, we talk of core and non-core both. And what is the importance of non-core engineers? They are of utmost importance, my friends. Let me talk about the huge amount of data analytics that the central ministry is updating daily to keep a daily record and track of the number of cases that are being registered, number of people that are being vaccinated, number of cases that are cured or sent back home, the oxygen bed oxygen supply, the bed supply in hospitals. All of these are to be kept in track, and most of this are being kept in track by software engineers or data analytics experts, which are doing their bit to maintain the record so that the transparency of the system is maintained, so that we generally get the update of how many COVID patients are being affected in which particular state. The government is releasing regular records, daily records of which are the most affected states, what is the death rate in that particular state. So this kind of data transparency is being maintained by the software engineers in particular. Now, apart from this, what can be done in the upcoming days by us engineers in this pandemic situation is we have to come up together. We need to design better systems. Like one of my friends over Facebook has suggested this particular mechanism of collecting data of the number of hospital beds or number of oxygen cylinders that are left in a particular hospital. And if we can make that particular data structure wherein we get all the records from the particular hospitals, the doctors in particular, which doctors are available, how many beds are available, how many oxygen cylinders are available, and in which particular hospital is it available, and we make a database which is shared with all the people, and that particular link can be accessed by all the people all throughout India, pan India, so that they can have an idea of which hospital has which number of beds, or which hospital or particular oxygen delivering agency has which number of oxygen cylinders. This is in progress. It has already been done by a few websites. They have made specific websites for this. You will get the link over Facebook. COVID-19 crisis management is something that they have put up to. Apart from this, they are trying to update that list daily, and that is what I would suggest as the software engineers come forward. We suggest you to make a rigorous database or data analytics, as my friend suggested over Facebook, that please we request you, if you're watching this video, make a rigorous database of the number of beds, the number of oxygen cylinders, the doctors that are available in particular hospitals, because the patients are running here and there, because I have seen a lot of chaos and a lot of worried people posting over Facebook regarding this unavailability of beds, unavailability of plasmas, blood supply, unavailability of the oxygen cylinders in particular. Please come out and help. And this is what we can do as engineers. We can increase the oxygen supply by thinking of several procedures. In fact, ISER has done has opened up a mini pilot oxygen delivering plant or oxygen manufacturing unit to produce oxygen oxygen that you need for the COVID patients, the liquid oxygen that you need, medical grade liquid oxygen production on a pilot plant scale, and they're providing the same with minimal budget that they had. And similarly, we can also, as individual groups, there have been suggestions in our university as well, there have been suggestions that we come up as a unit and we suggest ways to produce oxygen or extract oxygen from the air cheaply and transfer it to the locations that are not getting available amount of oxygen. Apart from this, transportation matrix can be designed so that the transportation of oxygen from one part of India to another part of India becomes easier, because Delhi has recently registered this particular problem wherein they have been given a quota of 480 tons of oxygen daily, but they are only receiving about 300 to 350 tons, as oxygen is getting hoarded up in the particular states it is being manufactured, and it is not reaching Delhi as clearly stated by Mr. Arvind Kejriwal, the Chief Minister of Delhi. And there is an oxygen crisis in Delhi in particular. And that's why we need to cater this issue. We need to have a proper designed transportation matrix. That is also, again, a task that is expected to be done by the by engineers in particular. And I am personally working on the transportation matrix, to be honest, that how that transportation can be improved from one part of India to another part of India with minimalistic traveling required, so that we can save time as well as money, and we can easily provide resources that are required in particular sectors or states. Other countries have also come up to help. US has come up to help. Pakistan has said that it will help with ambulances, and we really appreciate the efforts that the people are putting up, that the states are putting up, that the countries are putting up to help us. This is not a time when we criticize the government, or when we have been seeing a lot of Facebook posts where government criticism is taking place. Yes, definitely. The Madras High Court has correctly pointed out the Election Commission has been primarily responsible for this kind of an increase. The Mahakumbh has been primarily responsible for this kind of an increase. We do understand all of these issues, but the prime concern at the moment should be a proper data analytics approach, and more data-driven, and more of oxygen production-driven approach, where we have to look out for the solution. And as I have already told, these should be the approaches of the engineers, a few of which I'm personally working on. Particularly the oxygen production is a daily task that we are trying to do, 12 hours of duty every day for the frontline workers like us. And as human beings, we will have to go out of this bubble of fear, and we have to help those that are really in need. I have been personally helping COVID-19 patients in my colony with protection, definitely, so that I do not affect my personal hygiene, having said that, if you fear the COVID-19 patients, then that's not a solution, because they also need help, and you cannot let them die just because of your selfishness. So as humans, I would also request you, please come out of this bubble of fear and take protection, and then move ahead to help this COVID affected patients. They will be mentally and physically stable if you are with them, and try to help as much as you can, try to contribute as much as you can, particularly if you are fit enough to do so, particularly if you are if you have the ability, please utilize it. Do not sit idle at home, or do not criticize the government. Do not waste time posting on Facebook or social media. This is an awareness video. I wanted to get back to all of you. I will keep you posted about the advancements in this particular case, and also with the videos that I usually bring out, the technical topics. But I thought for particularly this kind of a situation, this video was very important for the awareness session. Other videos posted by other YouTube channels, you might refer to them. Dhruv Rathi has posted the few videos. Abhi and New particularly has posted this video about plasma donation. Yes, you can actually donate your plasma if you have been a COVID affected patient. Initially, you can refer to that video. Those are awareness videos, and you can actually take reference from them to extend your help to the ones in need. That is all I will be saying. Please, 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 as humans, as engineers, try to understand your role. Try to go beyond your boundaries and try to help, try to extend a helping hand. That is all I will say. Stay good, stay safe, stay healthy in this time of pandemic. If you liked our work, like it, share it with your friends, subscribe to our channel, and try spreading awareness. And one more thing, people have not been pressing that bell icon. If you do not press the bell icon, you will not get updates. That subscribers that are there on the channel are not getting regular updates because you have not pressed the bell icon just beside the subscribe button. In fact, I initially didn't know that as well. So just press that bell icon to get regular updates. Please, please try to help as much as you can other people. First, try to spread more awareness among people, and try to take actions. That's all. Thank you very much.